Hi, I'm Rongji. In today's video, I'll show you how to generate and demodulate the Bluetooth channel sounding signal using Keysight Signal Studio software and the XApps application. Bluetooth channel sounding is the latest breakthrough in high accuracy distance measurement, short for the HADM. It utilizes a new method called phase-based ranging, which analyzes the radio signal's phase to estimate device distance. To handle the issues like phase rotation rollover and enhance their security, it combines a time-of-flight method. By integrating phase data and the round-trip time information, this approach enables a more precise distance measurement between two devices. To measure this information, there are two packet structures commonly used. One is the CS sync packet and the other is CS torn packet. This can be used separately or combined with a guard interval as specified in the working mode section. In today's demo, I will show you the utilization of CS sync followed by the CS torn with 10 microseconds guard interval and 20 microseconds idle interval here. The CS sync packet handles the runtime trip information and is similar to the BRE1MAC physical encoded structure using modulated frequency shift keying carrier transmission. It has four fields: preamble, access address, trailer, and an optional payload data field. The optional field allows for either a sounding sequence with marker insertion or a random sequence with a date pattern here. The CS torn packet is associated with phase data information. It is transmitted using modulated amplitude shift keying over the scrambled antenna selection. Next, I will demonstrate how to generate this signal. So, let's start by opening up the Signal Studio and click on the Format button to access the menu. Here you will find support for both Classic and BRE modes. In this case, select the Bluetooth Low Energy mode. Moving up to Step 2, navigate to the BRE subpage and configure the BRE1MAC physical encoded layer. In the coding and modulation settings, choose the symbol rate as 1 max symbols per second and ensure that the coding state is turned off. Proceed to Step 3. Click on the package subpage. In the package type menu, you will see four options for channel sounding. In this case, let's select CS sync plus CS torn here. In Step 4, adjust the idle interval to 20 microseconds. Next, in Step 5, you can modify the channel index. The frequency will be coupled automatically. Moving on to Step 6, let's explore the sync settings. Open up the sequence type menu and choose the 32-bit sounding sequence. The settings for the marker position and the marker value will appear. Next, let's configure the CS tone settings. In this case, we'll do the frequency measurement and keep the frequency arrow at its default value. Finally, you can click on Provided button to generate and download the waveform to the connected signal generator. Next, let's switch over to the signal analyzer screen for the signal analysis. First, select the Bluetooth mode and choose Transmit Analysis with the Channel Sounding Results view. Moving on to Step 2, within the Bluetooth Transmit Analysis measurement, click on the measurement bar here and select packet type as BRE, CS sync plus CS torn. In Step 3, ensure that the physical layer is set to BRE1MAC physical layers. Next, in Step 4, modify the channel index to 2, and the corresponding frequency will adjust accordingly. To configure packet demodulation settings, let's go to the Mesh Setup, navigate to the Settings tab, click on the Config CS Packet button here. On the Sync Settings table, select the sequence type as 32-bit sounding sequence. For the CS tone settings, we'll keep the default. After do that, you can see that the channel sounding signal is correctly demodulated. The IF envelope trace indicates the accurate timing and the waveform structure. The demodulated waveform trace shows the frequency deviation versus the time. In the sync packet result, we can see that the payload date bit error rates are 0 out of 32, which is correct. In the CS tone packet result, the FFO is approximately 0 parts per million. The phase correction term and the stable phase are approximately 0 degree. These decoded results align with the demo setup. Next, let's proceed with some modifications in the CS tone packet based on the previous signal. This time, we'll adjust the FFO value to 1 parts per million. To do this, in the Signal Studio, navigate to the tone settings and modify the FFO value to 1 parts per million. Once done, generate the signal. After that, let's switch over to the analyzer screen. We can observe that the decoded FFO results show 1.17 parts per million now, which matches our expectations. Moving on to demo 3, let's make further modifications in the sync packet. To make these changes, first, let's revert FFO value back to 0 parts per million. Then, in the sync settings, choose the sequence type as 96-bit something sequence. Keep the mark position as default 1 and 68. Finally, generate the signal. After that, let's switch back to the analyzer screen. Click on the Config CS Packet button, and on the Sync Settings table, select the sequence type as 96-bit sounding sequence. After that, you will notice the signal is correctly demodulated. As we expected, the length of the sync packet has increased 3 times than before. This is evident in both the IF envelope trace and the demodulate waveform trace. Additionally, in the CS sync and tone packet results table, the payload bit arrows are now 0 out of 96, and the FFO value is 0.21 parts per million, which matches our expectations. We are continuously staying up to date with the latest Bluetooth specifications. Please keep updates from us. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website. Thank you for watching.